Angie. Hey, we're gonna learn it from Angie. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie.
That's me. Welcome to Engineering Expo. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go.
Hi, I'm Hannah, and I'm a design engineer at Spirit Aerosystems. And today, I have my friend with me.
Hi, I'm Kendra, and I'm Technical Capability Director at Koch Ag and Energy Solutions, and we're the leaders of Expo this year.
And today, we're going to be making roller coasters.
And here's the list of materials you'll need. Hannah, do you like roller coasters?
I love roller coasters.
Did you know that a big part of how a roller coaster works is gravity?
I did. And gravity is the invisible force that pulls everything down. For example, this marble to the table. To the table.
Well, today we're going to play with gravity.
And we're going to use paper to change the direction of the marble as it falls.
That sounds like fun. Let's get started. So the beginning of the design process is to sketch what we're going to build.
All right, I'll draw.
Remember to start with a high point so the ball falls all the way through your roller coaster.
Okay. Start with some tall pillars. My favorite part about a roller coaster is a loop. How about you?
Can we go upside down in the loop?
Let's do it.
All right.
So something like that.
No, oh my gosh. Okay, well, it needs to come back down too sometime. Is that too high?
You did say that the tallest point has to be at the beginning. Good catch.
Okay, well, I'll do that.
So maybe we just come around like this, do a fun spin.
I like it.
All right.
Let's build it.
Let's do it. So now that we have designed our roller coaster and planned it out, it's now time to build it. So we've provided to you a template that we'll be using today to build our roller coaster, and you can use that same template to build yours at home.
The template has dash lines and solid lines on it. You're going to fold on the dash lines and cut on the solid lines.
So for example, this is a support piece that we have cut out. And you'll see that you'll fold here along the dashed lines, and it will represent the supports here on our roller coaster.
We also have hill and loop pieces, and we have curve pieces. We'll show you how those work as we build our roller coaster.
And all three of those sections will come together to complete our final roller coaster.
Are you ready to build it?
I am.
Let's get started. Start cutting out your pieces.
Don't forget to cut on the solid lines and fold on the dashed lines. The first part of construction is your supports. Once you have taped them together to create a long tube, cut feet at one end so that you can tape it to your cardboard.
Then you tape the top of the hill to the top of your supports and tape all the pieces together before you start your design. Be sure to test your loop out as you go and then make changes in the design so that the marble goes down the hill.
It's important to test your design, and it's okay to change along the way. You want to problem solve to find solutions to errors that you might encounter.
Well, that was fun. We used our roller coaster to change the direction of the ball using gravity.
That's right. And remember, gravity is the invisible force that pulls everything down. Now, take out your engineering notebooks and sketch a unique design for a roller coaster of your own.
Thank you so much for taking time to design roller coasters with us.
We hope you had fun, and take a picture of either your designed sketch or your completed roller coaster and submit it on our event page for a chance to win a prize.
Until then,
see you next time.
So Hannah, have you ever been on a roller coaster?
I love roller coasters.
Oh my god.
She was like, wow. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie. This looks exactly like this. I think we could. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from
Angie. That's me. Thanks for joining us today. See you next time.